A few years ago, I had broken my leg, and as part of the healing process, started taking short walks. On one of my walks, I carried an old camera along and noticed these happy coincidences of color. Colorful objects, or people dressed in bright colors, matching their backgrounds. The simple, uncluttered pictures of everyday life reminded me of the city's forgotten beauty. I've been a Bombay boy, a Bombay wala, a Mumbaikar all my life. And for a long time, I've had this analogy that Mumbai was the most human of all the cities in the world. Looking at Bombay is like looking at humanity with its skin peeled back. The guts, the grime, the gore, all compressed in a tight space. Through my pretty color-coded pictures, I was going to put the skin back on the city, present it in a neat photo book. But walking every street over 3 years humbled me. At any given moment, I found there are so many stories, hopes, and dreams, all in communication and conflict with each other. How could any one narrative sum it all up? What started as a book about how the city looked turned into a book about what the city meant. Bombay, I realized, is not just a place. It's an idea. An idea that's always changing. It was seven islands, now it's one. It was called Bombay, and now it's called Mumbai. A city of dreams and an unforgiving host, ever-changing and complex. Simultaneously many Mumbais, and yet, still Bombay.